Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Adults. Okay, today is the day. The last video of the Persona 5 custom series is here, and I'm very excited to share with all of you. Our last Phantom Thief to join is Kasumi Yoshizawa, aka Violet. She is an extra character added in the game for the extended version, which will be Persona 5 Royal. Regarding her character, she is a first year student at Shujin Academy, for which she is seen calling Joker Senpai. On top of that, she is a very friendly girl and an excellent rhythmic gymnast. As I had mentioned in Crow's video, many on Instagram asked me to include her in this series, and I could not reject the idea, and here we have the video. And speaking of Instagram, in my account I have shared the concept art of the character along with the old concept of the Phantom Tits in the order in which I have worked in them. Wow, what can I say? I've been working on this series for 2 years and I'm very surprised it's over. Time flies! But anyway, all the good things have to end. Before I start, I wanna thank all the people who have supported my content on YouTube and stay until the end on all the videos in this series. I know that the first 3 videos are not the best due to the audio, since I had neither idea of how to make good edits back then, you guys enjoyed it no matter the problem. I made these videos out of pure love for this wonderful game that has honestly changed my life in a very rewarding way. I connected with people from all over the world, and I made good friends, and most of all, it made me feel very satisfied to be able to complete a project as big as this. In short words, thank you guys, thank you Joker and the Phantom Tits. You guys take my heart. And well, without more to say, let's get started. For the base though, I will use an Ever After High that I already working on previously, which is an apple white just seeing her skin color. The first thing, as always, will be to remove the old hair to start with the rest. Now with the head clean, it is time to do her hair. I will not make a wig since this time I will reroute her. So first I start to paint her bald head with red paint all over the area, staying this way. Next I take a strip of yarn and start to open it. Leaving it aside, I take my reroute tool and grab the strip of yarn and then graft it into the holes of the head. With that, I repeat the process filling all the holes in the area. I've not done this since the video of Panther, but to be honest, doing this is very tedious, as the needle used to grab the hair tends to break, and when I'm doing, I already broke like 4 needles, and yeah, this has been very frustrating. It is not necessary to fill all the holes, as I'm using yarn, and it will make it look very bulky. And this is how it looks. Although at the moment it looks like Ariel, this will change when I lower the balloon. But for now, I will secure each strip of yarn with silicone glue. And with the stick, I will spread it from the inside. Well, as you can see, I already lowered the balloon with the help of a brush and a hair strainer. And wow, this color really looks great on her. Off camera, I made her ponytail and separate the hair that will be her bangs later. Although, seeing her like that doesn't look bad either. She even looks like another character. With that, it's time to work on her face. With her hair covered and with 3 layers of MSC on her face, I start to work on the lines of the eyes. If you have noticed, this time my video will be more concise and thus I will avoid that you don't get bored with shots of speed process. With the line on her eyes finished, I begin to draw her eyebrows, trying to make them symmetrical. Forget it, I fail. The good thing is that this eraser helps me a lot to clean up my mistakes. With that, I continue drawing and begin to blush her cheeks, a little on her lips, and again on her cheeks so that she does not look so pale. With a white watercolor pencil, I fill her eyes as a base color along with others. Now with a red pencil, I will pass her as a base to the pupils. Also, with the same pencil, I will pass the color of her eyebrows. Now it is the turn of the black pencil to give more life to the lines that I draw. This part is seriously very satisfactory, it makes everything take shape. Again with the red pencil, I will make the pupils stand out more. And done with the pencil, it is time to give more light to the face with paint. As always, I only pass the parts that I want to pop up more, like the white of the eyes and a little of the eyelashes. With that, I put the brightness of her eyes very carefully. And I end up protecting everything with ultra glass. This time I will not put to the pupils, but I will put a little to the black dots on her eyes just to experiment. And this is how her face looks. Wow, it looks wonderful. Her eyelashes are so sharp and outlined that I'm speechless. Now that I'm done with the repaint, it is time to start to do her hairstyle. The first thing I will do is to protect her face with a piece of Ziploc bag to prevent her from getting dirty. With that, I sprinkle a little water to the area of her bends and I begin to comb it. And then I make the cut. With the help of a wet brush, I retouch her bends so that it looks like the character has it. Besides that, I pass in a little white glue to it so that it fits it more. Now with a little glue, I'll pass the top of her ponytail. As I did with Panther, I will make her ponytail have a balloon by putting yarn weights as extensions. I'm rolling it all and with the thread of yarn of the same color, I will hold it more. After having flipping over, I will mix it with the rest of the hair. With that, I'll make her ponytail look wavy with the help of my fingers. I could use a metal stick to make her curls, but it was a bit tricky for me to engrave it that way. So, I went for the reliable old one. With that done, I protected with hairspray. And that's it! I must say that she looks so elegant having made the curls. The best thing is that I can position her ponytail, which is perfect for photos. With a little piece of yarn, I made her sideburns. I could just draw them, but I don't do that. And as a last detail, I made her bow using a thin black ribbon. With that, I'll start making her Phantom Thief outfit. For her leotard, I decided to do everything with a potsy skull and I will mold it to her torso with the help of my tools and a little water to soften the clay. At first I was going to use fabric to do it, but I realized that this way is much faster and makes her figure look better. With that, I will cover everything with several layers of black paint, trying to avoid staining the parts of her skin. And with a layer of ultra glass, I will protect the paint and make the leotard have a shiny finish. Just look at it, it looks great with that touch! As you can see, I already marked the parts on her coat on the fabric, which I already joined. Now I will do the gathering on her slits using a thicker ribbon and with a needle I will pass the seam in the middle and then pull it. Adjust it a little and then iron it all. Looking like this. I already sewed it directly to the slits. And this is what her coat looks like after having put it all together. Definitely the key to doing this is patience. Now I will decorate it with 3D paint, making its buttons one by one and very carefully. With a fine brush I will paint them all with gold and I add some more details. And this is what it looks like. Also I take advantage and mark buttons on both sides on her sleeves and on the back of the tail of her coat. Off camera I made her stockings as you can see. The only thing I had to do with them is put them on both legs and thus advance with her shoes. And for that, I will reuse these monster high shoes that I had saved, which I will cut the part that I don't need with a scalpel, very carefully since I already cut myself with it. And this is how they look. I decided to keep this decoration since the truth is that doesn't look so bad. With a potsy, I modified them a bit so that they look more pointed and look like the original ones. With that, I will paint them with black paint. And just like the leader, I'll pass ultra glass so that the both pieces combine. Wow, how beautiful they look! With the same ribbon that I used in her hair, I made the decoration on her feet and used it to make her choker too. Now with red paint, I will paint her hands to make the gloves. staying this way. I will put them on each one. And this is how they look on her body. I must say the pose of her hands is perfect with this outfit, it looks great. As you can see, I took this little rose shaped earring and I completely modified it to make her belt with some details that I put with paint, including the cover of her sword. Looking like this on the doll's body. And speaking of her weapons, I made her sword using wood just like the other of the phantom tits. The best thing is that I can put it in the cover without any problem. And with the same wood, I made her fire weapon, which will be this rifle. And with that, her outfit is ready. To finish, I made her mask with the same way that I made Queen mask, using plastic and 3D paint. All I had to do is paint with several layers of black paint and paint the decoration between the eyes with silver. And this is how her mask looks, which Kasumi uses to call her persona Cendrillon. And to my surprise with this mask is that she doesn't need an elastic band. I just had to put under her bands and it completely fits it even if I make a move. I was not expecting this, seriously. And with that, Violet is ready. This doll being the last of the Persona 5 custom series was another challenge in my projects. Achieve those folds in her sleeves was more difficult than you think. I really thank all the people on Instagram who advised me on how to do them. But putting that aside, I'm very happy with the result I achieved with her. Without a doubt, with that outfit she is like the female Joker of the game. Well, with all the dolls finished, what do you think if we have one last presentation? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, the Phantom Tips of Hearts. Wow, I can't believe what I did. Seeing all the dolls together feels so amazing. I'm quite excited. And without a doubt, seeing this group photo feels so goddamn good. Thanks for watching this video and for having accompanied me in this journey making this series dedicated to this incredible RPG game. Subscribe to my channel for more content like this since I would really appreciate it. And tell me in the comments what has been your favorite Phantom Thief and why. Don't forget that you can also find me on Instagram and now on TikTok as The Hatter Dolls. My name is Eric and I will see you next time. Bye!